Welcome to the last Soviet hotel. The other day, as I was driving through Moscow, I passed this huge Soviet monolith of a building. On top is a hammer and sickle and the words Hotel Soviet. And so I've come, I've checked in, and let me give you a little tour. The last Soviet hotel in Russia. Let's do it. Check this place out. This place is like a museum more than it is a hotel. Now the first thing I want to do is to show you some of the famous guests that have stayed at the Hotel Soviet. Some of the great and the good of the world. Check these people out. The guests gallery. We've had all the greats. Nikolai Ceausescu. He was a nice guy. Margaret Thatcher. Lovely. Who was worse, Margaret Thatcher or Ceausescu? I'm not sure. We have here a very famous Russian singer, Alla Pugachova. Vasily Stalin, that's Stalin's son. He used to hang out here on the weekends. And I think what I consider the greatest guest of all, this guy. No, not Chris de Burgh, Chuck Norris. Look at Chuck. If this hotel is good enough for Chuck Norris, it's good enough for me. So just think of the guests who have walked along these corridors in the past. All kinds of mass murderers and killers, war criminals. The hotel was created in the early 50s as one of the best hotels in Moscow for visiting dignitaries. Now, I never went to this last night, but downstairs we have a Soviet nightclub. I'd love to have gone to the Soviet nightclub and bar, but I didn't. I was too tired. All right, let's jump in the Soviet lift. How many times can I say Soviet today? Let's go into the Soviet lift. Up to the next floor, please. While we're in the lift, I'll tell you, I paid £65 for the night at the Soviet hotel. The last Soviet hotel. Let's check out this floor. See what interesting things we can discover. Anything? Well, there's some people fixing the Soviet lift. The Soviet lift is broken down. We have some nice pictures on the wall here of old Papa Joe. There he is. Do you recognize that guy? Yosef Stalin. In this picture, he seems to have a very nice complexion, but in real life, he was embarrassed by his complexion because he had a very ruddy, potted face. Here we have who I believe is Marshal Zhukov, the defender of Moscow against the Germans. The defender of Moscow and defender of Russia, I suppose. And here we have a guy with the bushy eyebrows, Leonid Brezhnev. Look at all those medals. Every year, Brezhnev used to like to give himself a new few medals, although he did nothing to deserve them. So that's why he had a whole row of medals. He gave himself medals for wars he'd never even fought in. I like it. So just imagine the people who are walking here, Margaret Thatcher, Ceausescu, and all being spied on, no doubt. I expect that behind these mirrors is a little room. A room with like two-way cameras and stuff like that where they could spy on the guests and know that who was sleeping with who, get some information that he could blackmail you with later. There's a Soviet corridor. Hey, it's pretty quiet at this Hotel Soviet. Where should we go next? Ah, look what I've seen. It says here, staff only. Let's be naughty. Ah, secret staircase. Let's take the secret staircase. Where does it lead? Who knows? We're breaking rules at the Hotel Soviet. Hope I don't end up like Otto Weinberg. in North Korea. We're back on the floor below. All right. Yeah, so all these rooms in the past, I imagine, would have been bugged. There would have been people, there would have been a room somewhere with cameras and stuff and microphones listening to these guests. Because if Ceausescu was staying here and people like Margaret Thatcher and whoever other leaders, whichever other leaders of countries, they would have wanted to get that information from them. So they would have put them into this Soviet hotel where they knew they could have bugged them, they could have listened to things, kept an eye on them. That's what went down at the Hotel Soviet. Did I show you Khrushchev before? Hello, Khrushchev. That's where Stalin used to stay. Crikey, it's had some... There's probably not a hotel in the world that has had as many influential guests as the Hotel Soviet. Even Christa Berg. Wow. Or should I say, except Christa Berg. Lady in red. Right, welcome to the room here in the Hotel Sovietsky. Check it out. Hey, it's not a bad room, right? I mean, they could have gone more Soviet with the TV. They've put an LG in there, bit of a modern fridge. They should have had a big old noisy Soviet fridge. And I'm not sure if they had Soviet, if they had air conditioning in the Soviet Union. But a nice window to let the breeze in, because Moscow is about 30 degrees at this time of year. It's nasty. A nice comfortable bed, I can attest. I slept very well in it. Not a Soviet bed. I imagine Soviet beds are pretty hard. And here's the Soviet bathroom. The piece de resistance. This is where you can have your Soviet poo, your Soviet shave, and your Soviet shower. If that's what you want to do. Remember what I was saying before about secret places and cameras and stuff? Well, check this out. Look here, there's a mirror here at the end of the corridor, and it opens. And behind it is a room. Let's have a look. Wow. A secret Soviet room. You see, you never know what you discover at the Hotel Soviet. Secret Soviet rooms, hidden behind mirrors. I want to show you down here what's down here. This old Soviet restaurant. The bar and stuff. Let's see if we can have a look. It's pretty magnificent. Let's see if they let us in. Just have a little look. Здравствуйте, можно посмотреть? Спасибо большое. Check this out. This is the Soviet bar. A Soviet bar. So imagine the flirting that went on here with the Soviet babushkas in the past. I bet there's some right hotties here. Look how beautiful it is. This is it. Oh. And here in the other room is the Soviet dining hall. So imagine the parties that went on here. Check this out. This is the hotel's dining room. What do you reckon to that? Here they would have had Soviet bands playing. I'm trying to think who was a famous Soviet band. I don't know, they must have had an equivalent to the Beatles. But no doubt they played in here. Look at the ceiling. That's the interesting thing about coming to these Soviet places. Crikey, how many times have I said Soviet today? Is you can imagine the life that went on before in them, you know? This huge experiment was done behind closed doors, the Soviet Union. They weren't allowed out and we weren't allowed in. But I suppose they had lives much like us. People picking each other up at the bar, taking them up to the room. Maybe some hard currency ladies of the night were working here. All right, let's go and have a little shot of vodka to end the tour of the Hotel Soviet. Oh, actually, there's a Soviet toilet. Let's see what a Soviet toilet looks like. It's locked. It's locked. We'll never know. The great mystery. We'll have to come back and do a second video one day just to film inside the Soviet toilet. Welcome to the Hotel Sovietsky.
Any time, a place.
And look here. There's a Soviet lady. Hello, Soviet lady.
Hello.
Are you enjoying your stay at the Hotel Soviet?
Yes.
Me too.
Well, I have a few shots of vodka, but there is no ticket discount.
No Wild Swan or Wild Hunt vodka. What is it? Wow, it's strong. All right, listen, that's enough from the Hotel Soviet. Are you having vodka?
No.
Why would I wait for you? We're not waiting for her. This is it. Goodbye from the Hotel Soviet. It's been emotional. Hope you enjoyed it. It's on booking.com, by the way, so if you want to book a night here, it's on booking.com. You can do. All right. So many more adventures in Soviet hotels across Russia, hopefully. Bloody hell. 50 grams is a big shot of vodka, I didn't realise. Wah. All right. Goodbye from the Hotel Sobieski. До свидания.